Tizier usually involve many effects on the central nervous system, biological system of our body. From loss of consciousness, analgesia, inhibition for sensory and motor reflexes beside muscle, full muscle relaxation. And we can note, as we say in the beginning of this lecture, use all this effect by single drugs without broad use in a practice of general combination of different drugs. قسمناها إلى drugs that used before operation, سميناها بالبري surgical أو بري medication, aims to sedation, analgesia, if there is pre-existing inhibition for parasympathetic system to avoid excessive salivation, bronchial secretion, any tendency for bronchospasm, or reflex, decreased reflex, bradycardia and hypotension that can be induced by some general anesthetic agents. Prophylaxis for especially those risky patients, ذكرناهم اللي هم the pregnant women, those with incompetent of gastroesophageal reflexes, full stomach, and so on. After post-operative medication, ensure warning of what muscle relaxant and opioids or narcotic and analgesic drugs that lead to respiratory depression, reconscious of patient, treatment of pain, post-operative analgesic or by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. The drug used during operation, that means general anesthesia. We have two types of general anesthesia. General anesthesia represented by a thiazone of edomediate and so on. Ages, the induction of general anesthesia done by intravenous anesthetic agent and inhalational anesthesia. Inhalational anesthesia to the respiratory system for men anesthesia to the respiratory system with as at room temperature, including nitrous oxide and cyclobrobin, while volatile liquid general anesthetic agent, ether and halothene group or halogenated group, including halothene and fluorine, fluorine, sulfone, and so on. تكلمنا عن الإفكت جنرال أنستيزيا of our body and taking the first mechanism of action and also pharmacokinetic factor affecting on uptake and distribution, particular distribution of general anesthetic according to what is called gradient. ومني فاكتور قلنا عليها solubility is the major one, anesthetic concentration, pulmonary ventilation, pulmonary blood flow, through elimination also. وحكينا على the first anesthetic agent, nitrous oxide, وقلنا بأنه يكون gas at room temperature with sweet odor can cause love, its advantage. It is characterized by rapid onset of action and rapid recovery. Why? حكينا عليها due to low solubility in the blood. Second one, neither inflammable nor explosive. So diathermy, safe during surgery, has strong analgesic action, produce light anesthesia without demonstrable depressing for respiratory and vasomotor center, and reduce the requirement for more potent toxic general anesthetic in what is called the second gas effect. A disadvantage of it, حكينا عليها المحاضرة السابقة أيضا, أنه nitrous oxide has little muscle relaxant effect. So it must be administered with more potent anesthetic and muscle relaxant to produce a state of full surgical anesthesia. Contraindication, clinical use is because it has strong analgesic effect, can be using for emergency management of injuries during post-operative physiotherapy and for refractory pain of terminal illnesses. ذكرنا أنه when the clinical uses in surgery in the induction or maintenance, in the maintenance of general anesthesia. But because it has little muscle relaxant effect, must be combined with other surgical general anesthetic agent and muscle relaxant drugs in maintenance of anesthesia. بالإضافة إلى أنه can be using in sub-anesthetic dose to maintenance analgesia in some obstetric practice, لأنه قلنا تأثير يكون not toxic and little effect on the uterus because it has little muscle relaxant effect. بينما ذكرنا الهالوجينيتد جروب الهالوثين انفلورين ايزوفلورين potent muscle relaxant. For this reason can be used in intrauterine fetal manipulation, change position of fetus مثل ما حكينا, but carried risk of postpartum hemorrhage due to uterine atony. تكلمنا على الكونترا انديكيشن, هذا رابيد ريفيجن محاضرتنا السابقه. تكلمنا على الكونترا انديكيشن اوف نايتروس اوكسايد, لانه ادمنستريشن, هاي الحقيقه اللي موجوده انه ادمنستريشن اوف نايتروس اوكسايد ان اور بودي ويل ليد تو اكسباند وات از كولد الكلوزد جاز فولد سبيس ان اور بودي لايك البريتونيوم البلورا البريكارديوم, كلها يصير بها اكسبانشن during administration of nitrous oxide. لذلك contraindication in case of what intestinal obstruction, occlusion of middle ear, chronic obstructive airway disease, arterial thrombolism. According to this principle. حكينا على أنه nitrous oxide has what is called a سوينا شنو diffusion hypoxia. وعرفنا شنو diffusion hypoxia نتيجة low solubility of some anesthetic gases. يصير لها rapid elimination from the alveoli, lead to displacement oxygen from the alveoli, lead to type of hypoxia called diffusional hypoxia. To overcome this problem, Guinness mixture of nitrous oxide with oxygen in 50%. This mixture can be necessary during recovery, especially in elderly. This is called حكينا ايضا على drug interaction, قلنا يا بتر المكسجر of nitrous oxide with oxygen combined with more toxic and more potent general anesthetic like الهالوثين in order to reduce requirement of their dosage, the later one more toxic like الهالوثين by 50%. وقلنا هنا carried risk of what adverse effect of الهالوثين, severe hepatic toxicity. لذلك can be useful to be combined with this combination with nitrous oxide and oxygen to reduce the dose and consequently its effect, side effect, in what is called the second gas effect of the nitrous oxide. This is the first advantage of it. Our lecture today, نذكر نكمل محاضرتنا بالvolatile liquid. بالمناسبة cyclobrobin, also gaseous at room temperature, but not used in practice of general anesthesia nowadays because it is explosive. Second point, because it is also enhanced or sensitization of heart for catecholamine and an increased risk of cardiac arrhythmias. نجي على second part اللي هي volatile liquid agents اللي تكون like الإيثر والهالوجينيتد جروب. الإيثر أو diethyl ether, it is irritant, أيضا general view about it. Flammable, nana يكون بعكس النيتروس أوكسيد اللي قلنا it is not explosive, neither inflammable, لذلك هو safe diathermy, هنا لا يكون inflammable and explosive. Bad odor, colorless and highly volatile liquid inhalational anesthesia. The advantages اللي يكون more potent and reliable anesthetic agent. The vasomotor center is resistance to the dose required for full anesthesia. وهذا قلنا جدا مهم. لاحظنا بالنيتروس اوكسايد ايضا produce light anesthesia without what demonstrable effect on the vasomotor center or respiratory center. Full muscle relaxation achieved in deep anesthesia by diethyl ether. بينما كان بالنيتروس اوكسايد واحدة من الديزادفانتج مالته هو little muscle relaxant effect. نشوف وي diethyl ether لا. full muscle relaxation achieved in deep anesthesia by using diethyl ether. Number four, it is a bronchodilator. حكينا محاضرتنا وقلنا معظمهم يكون شنو general anesthetic, gaseous anesthetic, bronchodilator used to treat bronchospasm, resistance to the other drugs. لكنه يكون irritant to upper respiratory tract. Irritant أقصد increase salivation, bronchial secretion, increased tendency for laryngospasm. كلها causes irritation for upper respiratory by diethyl ether, although it is bronchodilator. Number five, النقطة المهمة بالدايثيل إيثر. Doesn't sensitization, it doesn't sensitize the heart for catecholamine or other sympathomimetic agent. بمعنى أنه there is no fear of cardiac arrhythmias. No fear of cardiac arrhythmias. So there is full muscle relaxation, doesn't sensitization for catecholamine. وهذا أيضا بنفس الوقت doesn't sensitize heart for catecholamine carried risk of what? Cardiac depressant. يعني can be potentiate action of what? Beta blocker lead to cardiac depressant effect or maybe cardiac arrest if that can combination with high dose like with diethyl ether and the beta blocker. It is full muscle relaxation, so it is potentiate action of which group of muscles? Of drug, sorry. Yes, muscle relaxant group. Muscle relaxant or neuromuscular blocking drugs with because it is full muscle relaxation can be achieved by deep anesthesia. لعد شنو disadvantage هنا أنا؟ مثل ما ذكرنا هو explosive, flammable. So contraindication diathermine surgery with using of ether. Number two, irritant. Leading to excessive bronchial and salivary gland secretion with laryngospasm. All these effects can be stopped by using what antimuscarinic drug, اللي قلنا عليها pre-operative medication to avoid such irritation can be induced by some anesthetic agent like the ether by antimuscarinic drugs, atropine, can be overcome on the irritation induced by diethyl ether. Bad odor, بينما nitrous oxide can sweet odor. أيضا frequent post-operative nausea and vomiting. Frequent severe post-operative nausea and vomiting also noticed with high incidence in, with using of what? Diethyl ether. Induction and recovery period in anashbia راح يكون in very long. ليش? Because it's highly solubility in the blood, highly soluble in the blood. بينما nitrous oxide ذكرنا الكمبارزم هاي تكون حتى سهولة الحفظ نيتروس أوكسيد قلنا لو سوليوبل إن ذا بلاد وبالتالي راح يصير رابيد إندكشن رابيد ريكفري لكنه هنا الإندكشن أند ريكفري بيريدز آر فيري لونج وذ دايثيل إيثر دو تو هاي سوليبلتي بيكوز إت إز هايلي سوليوبل إن ذا بلاد فأكو أدفانتجز ديز أدفانتجز اللي هي إكسبلوسيف فليمبل irritation for upper respiratory tract, bad odor, frequent post-operative nausea and vomiting, beside long period for recovery, for induction and recovery, because it's highly soluble in the blood. The ether can be, when استخدمنا الإيثر for also maintenance of anesthesia, maintenance anesthesia and surgery. Contraindication, severe hepatic disease, you know, can be lead to hepatotoxicity and leukocytosis. لذلك severe liver damage can be induced, contraindication with diethyl ether. Also number two, an increased CSF pressure, cerebrospinal fluid pressure, also contraindicate to patient with diethyl ether. Non-precautions in using with children, febrile children treatment, this risk of convulsion. لأنه قلنا معظمهم هنا carried risk of what, خاصة الهالوجينيتد carried risk of hyperthermia. Dangerous use diathermy مثل ما ذكرنا because it is a flammable explosive. And in pregnancy lead to respiratory depression in fetus, postpartum hemorrhage. ليش يصير postpartum hemorrhage with diathyl ether؟ لأنه قلنا full muscle relaxation can induce uterine atony. any fourth uterine contraction, so carried risk of postpartum hemorrhage. Drug interaction, diethyl ether, gonna potentiate action of what? Muscle relaxant or neuromuscular blockers, because it is strong or potent muscle relaxant, can potentiate effect of neuromuscular blocker drugs. And number two, أيضا قلنا تأثير على الهارت, does insensitization heart for الكاتيكولامين. So potentiate effect of beta blockers, خذناه في محاضرات الأدرينيرجيك سيستم, can lead to decrease the force of ventricular contraction, bradycardia, and may lead to cardiac depressant effect. This is related a few points about diethyl ether والمقارنة بينه وبين النيتروس أوكسيد. الفروقات قلنا بالنسبة للنيتروس أوكسيد rapid induction rapid recovery, لكن diethyl ether لا, very long period of induction and recovery due to high solubility in the blood. قلنا النقطة الأخ أنه muscle relaxant effect يكون potent with the diethyl ether, لكنه little muscle relaxant in nitrous oxide. Nitrous oxide قلنا neither inflammable nor explosive, safe diathermy in surgery. هنا يكون explosive, flammable, so contraindication in diathermy in surgery with diethyl ether. And other points اللي قلنا عليه أيضا vasomotor center, both of them is safe. And light anesthesia without demonstrable depressing for motor center, respiratory center, vasomotor center, respiratory center. Well, direct interaction with contraindication. The most important group, the halogenated agent, the halothene, prototype of this group, أيضا هو gas. Note, is highly volatile liquid at gas temperature, the halothene. Colorless, volatile, no, not irritant, non-irritant. With a sweet odor. هسه المقارنة الهالوثين ويا الدايثيل إيثر أن يكون أيضا غاز or highly volatile liquid, highly volatile liquid at room temperature, لكن يكون also colorless, يكون not irritant. هذا الفرق بينما كان دايثيل إيثر irritant for upper respiratory tract. A sweet odor, لكنه كان like a bad odor دايثيل إيثر. Neither inflammable nor explosive like nitrous oxide, axial diethyl ether liquid at room temperature, highly volatile liquid at room temperature. Then can be distinguishing between the halothene and diethyl ether. Not irritant, sweet odor, neither inflammable or explosive. لكن diethyl يكون irritant, bad odor, flammable and explosive. Advantages of the halothene, also potent. Important general and general anesthetics induce a smooth and rapid induction and rapid recovery from anesthesia. مثل nitrous oxide due to low solubility. Why? Rapid induction, rapid recovery with a smooth and rapid induction, rapid recovery due to low solubility in the blood. وبالتالي not like diethyl ether اللي قلنا very long period of induction and recovery due to highly solubility. No effect on the bronchial and salivary secretion, بينما لاحظنا تأثير diethyl يكون irritant for upper respiratory. There is enhanced secretion of bronchial secretion, salivary secretion with an increased tendency for laryngospasm. لكن هنا يكون الهالوثين not effect on bronchial and salivary secretion. Number four, low incidence of post-operative nausea and vomiting. بينما كان بالدايثيل إيثر frequent post and severe post-operative nausea and vomiting. لعد شنو disadvantage of الهالوثين? Severe hepatitis. Severe hepatitis may be fatal. Maybe fatal hepatitis. ولذكرنا أنه to avoid this adverse effect, the major adverse effect بالحقيقة of the major adverse effect and disadvantage of the more potent and more toxic halogenated, اللي هو الهالوثين, is to be what? Combined with mixture of nitrous oxide and oxygen. This will reduce 50% of therapeutic dose of الهالوثين, and by this can avoid this adverse effect, major adverse effect, particularly severe hepatitis, especially noticed with those using frequently exposure for الهالوثين. يعني ذولاك اللي يستخدمون general anesthetic اللي يتعرض إلى general anesthetic less than 3 months, 3 أشهر, في أقل من 3 أشهر يصير شنو, and use liver injury and severe hepatitis with leukocytosis and maybe fatal. وعادة هنا هو الهالوثين الحقيقة nowadays replaced by الايزوفلورين. الايزوفلورين السيفوفلورين اللي تكون less toxic on the liver. Yes, so disadvantage, severe hepatitis, maybe fatal. And avoid its adverse effect and reduce its dose. And should be combined with muscle relaxant patient. Muscle relaxant to prepare patient for surgery. It suppresses sympathetic activity, yes, but sensitizes the heart for catecholamine. لكن لو حكينا على الدايثيل ايثر قبل شوي قلنا doesn't sensitization heart for catecholamine. وبالتالي كان بوتنشيت افكت وذ وات وذ البيتا بلوكر ليد تو كاردياك ديبرسنت. هنا لا, الهالوثين sensitize the heart for catecholamine, so there is carried risk of what cardiac arrhythmias. على الرغم من ما حكينا قلنا يا بترى هو stimulate for the vagal center lead to bradycardia, وذكرنا محاضرة الأولى أنه كان most potent negative inotropic effect هو أيضا الهالوثين, فهو direct بالحق بهاي الحالة الهالوثين هو direct what cardio depressant effect. Why? Or because negative inotropic effect and negative chronotropic effect from stimulation of the vagal center lead to bradycardia. Catecholamine and hepatic damage, maybe fatal hepatitis induced, can be overcome this problem by with mixture, must be combined with mixture of nitrous oxide with oxygen and halothene in halving the dose and avoid this major adverse effect. Drug interaction also like diethyl ether potentiate what? Antihypertensive drugs, شلون؟ لأنه cardiodepressant decrease cardiac output and by this decrease or potentiate hypertensive drugs. Giving atropine to reduce the risk of hypotension, yes, as an antimuscarinic drug because it stimulates the vagal center. Any fluorine, less potent than halothene, cardiorespiratory depressant, less metabolized than halothene in the liver. بالمناسبة الهالوثين metabolized in the liver by about 20% of its dose and lead to hepatic enzyme inducer. Considered halothene hepatic enzyme inducer and may lead, as we see in high doses, to severe hepatitis with leukocytosis. لكن هنا نشوف الانفلورين less potency than halothene. Yes, can cause cardiorespiratory depressant, less metabolized in the than in the liver than the halothene. النقطة المهمة نشوفها, not sensitized the heart for the catecholamine. يعني تأثير الانفلورين على الليفر يكون أقل, وعلى الهارت أيضا الكارديك arrhythmias ما موجودة. No risk of cardiac arrhythmias because not sensitized the heart for circulatory catecholamine. واضح اخوان الفرق بين الانفلورين والايز والهالوثين, يكون less metabolized the liver وبالتالي تاثير الانفلورين على الليفر يكون اقل من توكسيسيتي او في الهالوثين. بالاضافه النقطه المهمه الانفلورين no sensitized heart for catecholamine like diethyl ether, no sensitized heart for catecholamine, so no risk of cardiac arrhythmias. الايزوفلورين انترميديت بوتنسي بين الهالوثين والانفلورين. الايزوفلورين انترميديت بوتنسي بين الهالوثين والانفلورين استبيلايزز الهارت ريذم. شخص من يقول استبيلايزز الهارت ريذم، كان الهالوثين يسوي شنو؟ انكريس سنسيتايزيشن تو ذا كاتيكولامين لي تو كارديك اريثمياز، بينما الانفلورين نو سنسيتايز الهارت فور الكاتيكولامين and lead to cardiac depression. لكنه الايزوفلورين لا، intermediate effect lead to stabilizes the heart decrease. وحكيناها المحاضرة الأولى decrease systolic blood pressure due to what not effect on the cardiac output negative direct negative cardiac depression but due to decrease vascular resistance total peripheral resistance lead to decrease the main arterial blood pressure. والايزوفلورين النقطة المهمة أيضا قلنا هو المين أور البوتنت مصر الريسبيراتوري ديبرسنت، أيضا بوتنت مصر الريسبيراتوري ديبرسنت باي الايزوفلورين. This is a few points about the halogenated اللي هنا من مجموعة الانيليشنال انستيزيا. نجي هنا على الانترافيس انستيزيا وذكرناهن اللي هنا الثايوبنتون أو الثايوبنتال. هنا they are highly lipid-soluble، لازم يكون شنو highly lipid-soluble حتى شنو enter and reach to the brain tissue cerebral tissue rapidly. الأكشن مالتها مثل ما ذكرنا المحاضرة الأولى أنه لازم يكون cerebral correlation ما بين cerebral anesthesia and oxygen tension أو sorry anesthetic tension for the gaseous or for the lipid for intravenous anesthesia. There is correlation. كل ما كان the constant tension of anesthetic material عالية كل ما كان the cerebral anesthesia أيضا well. So highly soluble reach to the CNS rapidly and have extremely rapid induction. Rapid induction. Intravenous anesthesia can be eliminated by redistribution to the adipose tissue. يعني هنا النقطة المهمة أنه شلون يصير termination for the effect of intravenous lipid highly lipid soluble intravenous anesthetic agent by redistributed of intravenous anesthesia from cerebral tissue to the adipose tissue and other tissue where they are inactive there. الثايوبنتون الثايوبنتال هو بالحقيقة شنو very short acting barbiturate group of anxiolytic antihypnotic اللي أخذتوها محاضرات الهيبنوتيك دراكس بداية CNS lectures. يكون الثايوبنتون هو related to what barbiturate group very short acting barbiturate extensively bound to the plasma protein giving طبعا شنو برانترال intravenously rapid induced hypnosis and anesthesia without analgesia. لاحظون هنا أن type of anesthesia produced by thiobentone هو hypnosis, rapid induced hypnosis. هسا نشوف الـ duration مالتهم without analgesia. Hypnosis, muscle relaxation أكو أيضا لكنه شنو without analgesia. Distributed extensively in the highly vascular tissue of the brain, then subsequently diffused selectively into fatty tissue where it is, مثل ما ذكرنا, pharmacologically be inactive. Advantages of a thiobentone هنا أنا act quickly, rapid onset of action within about 30 seconds, يعني من التغطية intravenously, induce induction, induce hypnosis, and anesthesia with muscle relaxation but without analgesia as we see within 30 seconds نص دقيقة. The anesthetic effect at duration of action and persists for 4 to 7 minutes يعني useful and short operation or brief operation. Anesthesia induced by thiobentone it is pleasant without excitement. Pleasantly induced without excitement, مثل ما ذكرنا, rapidly act within 30 minutes and lasting for 4 to 7 minutes, useful in brief operation. شنو disadvantages مالته؟ Insignificant, مثل ما ذكرنا, insignificant analgesic effect, insignificant analgesic effect, and very short muscle relaxant effect. very short, قلنا for about 5 minutes, 5 دقائق فقط, muscle relaxation with hypnosis. لذلك must be combined with other more potent anesthetic agent. ولذلك استخدمنا clinically for induction of anesthesia only, not in maintenance. إذا تذكرون المحاضرة الأولى. The intravenous anesthetic agent due to short period of action using only for what? Induction of anesthesia due to very short duration of action. بالإضافة إلى أنها يكون non-significant analgesic effect. Clear? So cannot be used alone in anesthesia due to short period of action. Clinical uses of thiobentone, as we see, for induction of anesthesia prior to administration of inhalational or other more potent anesthetic agent. The contraindication of thiobentone, if number one, allergy to the barbiturate, of course, logical. إذا كان أكو allergy to the barbiturate, contraindication to use what? Thiobentone anesthesia. Severe cardiovascular disease or hypotension. احنا نعطي شنو؟ نعطي intravenously, نعطي intravenously rapid, نعمل side effect rapid injection lead to severe hypotension, heart disease or hypotension contraindication. Number three, obstructive airway disease like status asthmaticus, Addison disease also contraindication, primary adrenal insufficiency, hepatic dysfunction, myxoid hypothyroidism. All these contraindication to using a thiobentone. Short period of apnea is could be occurred or developed. Rapid injection lead to severe hypotension, coughing, sneezing with laryngeal spasm. It is a state of analgesia with light. Type of anesthesia produced by ketamine, one who is known as dissociative anesthesia, the state of analgesia with light hypnosis. يعني عكس الانستيزيا used by what? الثيوبنتون, اللي هي كانت hypnosis, muscle relaxation with no significant what? Analgesic effect. لكن شوف هنا لا, يعني اكو شنو profound analgesic effect or strong analgesic effect with light hypnosis. يعني يكون مثل ما نقول in Arabic نص ونص التخدير مالته. لذلك anesthesia produced by ketamine is not potent and or effective. Not potent or effective. Why? Because there is yes a state of analgesia but light hypnosis and muscle relaxation. لذلك advantage produce أو disadvantage إنه راح يصير لأنه no muscle relaxant effect, yes light hypnosis and anesthesia. Hallucination can occur during recovery. Hallucination, it increase the heart and increase intracranial, العفو heart rate, يعني increase blood pressure, increase intracranial pressure and CSF pressure. Why? Because it has sympathomimetic activity. Sympathomimetic activity. Administration of ketamine produce anesthesia, profound analgesic with light hypnosis, dissociative anesthesia with sympathomimetic effect. With sympathomimetic effect. Yes, it is helping blood pressure maintenance, help in normal blood pressure maintenance, but overdose can lead to an increased blood pressure beside an increase intracranial pressure, CSF pressure, and intraocular pressure of eye. Less vomiting incidence and produce anesthesia for 15 minutes, not like thiobentone اللي قلنا عليه for what? 4 to 7 minutes only, 5 minutes. In an anesthesia duration of action by ketamine, 15 minutes characterized by what? Profound or strong analgesic effect. بينما كانت الانستيزيا produced by thiobentone very short 4 to 7 minutes and insignificant with insignificant analgesic effect. Less vomiting incidence than thiobentone اللي قلنا يصير ويا frequent nausea and vomiting. Production of NSC associated with symbiothomimetic effect وهذا قلنا help in maintenance normal blood pressure and rarely it rarely induce bronchospasm. لذلك useful in asthmatic patient عكس الثايوبنتون اللي يمكن يصير لارنجوسبازم and short period of apnea. لذلك contraindication قلنا عليه الثايوبنتون in state of asthmaticus or other chronic obstructive airway disease. بينما الكيتامين can be using in such cases like asthmatic patient because it is rarely induced bronchospasm. Clear? The clinical uses لأن أكو profound analgesic effect بالنسبة للكيتامين can be sub-anesthetic dose used to provide analgesia for painful procedure of short duration. For example, bone marrow aspiration or sampling and radiotherapeutic procedures. A short procedure لكنه painful. Need for sub-anesthetic dose of ketamine to provide analgesia for such conditions. Used for induction and maintenance of anesthesia for short-lasting procedures that don't require muscle relaxation. The contraindication, moderate and severe hypertension. ليش moderate and severe hypertension why يحصل هنا contraindication؟ لأن قبل شوية قلنا أنه يا بترى carried risk of symbathomimetic effect. Yes, it is help maintenance normal blood pressure during surgery, but may carried risk of hypertension, increase the blood, يعني also intracranial pressure, intraocular pressure, maybe increase moderate and severe hypertension, congestive heart failure, history of CVA or cerebral trauma or any condition associated with an increased intracranial pressure. وهذا related to the symbathomimetic activity of the ketamine. Chronic alcoholism, eye injury with an increased intraocular pressure. هذا كله logic according to related to the symbathomimetic activity related with the ketamine use. أيضا psychiatric disorder or for example schizophrenia. Psychiatric disorder for example schizophrenia. Why? لأنه قلنا أنه ممكن يحصل recovery period what? Hallucination. إذا تذكرون hallucination can be occur in recovery period. During recovery can be obviously not still contraindication in patient psychiatric patient or those taking like schizophrenia. أنا أتوقف هنا عن إن شاء الله أكمل المحاضرة القادمة. شكرا لكم.